So we've got this GHD, glute-ham developer, and we're gonna go over how we use it and why we use it. And that'll be the other question that comes up. So why do we use this? If the best way to train your core and develop midline stabilization is through the 9 foundational movements and other functional movements such as Olympic lifts, then why this machine? And answers up here. Again, my handwriting not so good and had a pen running out of ink, but 3 main reasons why we use the GHD. First one is kinesthetic awareness, body control. We're learning to control the erectors back here through some of the movements that we're gonna do. So body awareness, body control, how to control flexion, how to control extension, make the muscles activate in the correct patterns. Number 2 is communication. So when you tell an athlete, I want to see flexion or I want to see extension, they may not know what that means. We can easily develop that communication on what those things mean on this machine here. And lastly, I've got down here is we can train under no load. So our mantra for CrossFit is what? Mechanics, consistency, and then intensity. So those 9 foundational movements are crucial for training the core and developing that musculature of the core. But at first, we have to get the mechanics down before we add the intensity that can really build those up. So we've got to get that air squat down before we really add a load that's going to develop some of that musculature. And with this, we can jump in safely right away. The mechanics are fairly easy. And even for a well-developed athlete, hip extensions, sit-ups on here, et cetera, is going to work them without even adding any load. So we can start to develop that in something that's safe and not intimidating. You get grandma in here, she might be intimidated by the barbell and the big rubber plates or metal plates, but you know, no weight, it's not intimidating. So the ability to train and develop under no load, crucial in the beginning and you know, can be used throughout an athlete's career. First one we're going to do is this hip extension, which is the most basic move. If you look where Nadia set this up, so she's got teeny tiny legs, so she had to move this foot pad all the way up here. But for hip extension, what we want, because we're going to be dynamic in the hip, we need to make sure that her hip joint is out in front of the pad. It could be even further if she wanted. So it's free to move. So Nadia's going to demo a few for us, maybe 2 or 3. Again, hip extension, hip flexion. So this is the hip extension exercise. And what we've got here is Nadia is dynamic in the hip, static in the trunk. She's maintaining that lumbar curve. Let's talk about progressing there. So if you have a new athlete, new to this machine, first thing you may do is just a Superman hold. So Nadia is gonna set up there, hold the position. This might be the first step for your athlete. And this is gonna be challenging, especially you make them do it for 30 seconds, a minute. All this is firing right here. Again, we're resisting that flexion. We're utilizing the abs in the way that they're gonna be utilizing running, jumping, deadlifting, keeping that lumbar curve set. Next thing is we might ask her only to go to a couple inches down and up. And then once she shows capacity there, all the way up, all the way down. And relax. So this is hip extension. This is one where we're really safe for adding that intensity piece. Why? Because we've got that lumbar curve set just like we've taught you all weekend long. The back is safe. We can increase intensity by increasing speed. We can do a lot of reps here. We can add weight. She could hold plates across her chest, across the back. We've got that lumbar curve locked in nice and tight. Again, safe to ramp up that intensity relatively quickly once they demonstrate a capacity there. All right, we'll move on to back extension. So back extension, Nadia is gonna move this up, or back, my bad. Because back extension, we're gonna want the hip joint to be on top of the pad so we can quote unquote trap that hip joint. So it's not gonna be free to move because we wanna be, now in back extension, we wanna be static in the hips and dynamic in the trunk. So with the back extension, static in the hips, dynamic in the trunk, we're gonna intentionally lose that lumbar curve and our good back position. So this is gonna be the opposite of everything you guys have learned and done thus far into the cert. We're doing it on purpose so we gain control and awareness and strength and isolating for strength work in the erectors of the back. So it's an intentional loss of this curvature to kind of isolate and work on here. And what's gonna happen is hips trapped. She's gonna extend kind of one vertebrae at a time in a snake-like motion and finish at the neck. And then back down, she's gonna curl one vertebrae at a time. Takes a ton of body control and a lot of strength in the erectors. You can really really build those up there. Now, again, static in the trunk, or static in the hip, dynamic in the trunk on this one. Now with this back extension, you have to be careful with ramping up that intensity because the back is exposed. So just like a deadlift with my back rounded, increased chance of disc and spinal injury. So same thing here, it's an intentional loss. You want your athletes to have a lot of capacity before introducing this. And before putting this into a Metcon, they should show a lot of capacity and control here as well. You have to be kind of careful about how fast you do these and how many reps. So just be smart. All right, let's move on to the last one. The most advanced is hip and back extension. So she's going to move the GHD back up to where the hip's going to be free. So hip and back extension, we're going to be dynamic in both the hip and the back and the trunk. So a little combo move here. So as Nadia gets set up. Again, now she's moved up to where her hip is well out in front of the pad. It's gonna look real similar to that back extension, except we're gonna add one more joint, which is gonna be the hip joint. So she's gonna start up here at the neck with the curl down, one vertebrae at a time. Now instead of stopping with that last vertebrae, she adds the hip, and now opens the hip joint, and then works one vertebrae up at the top, and back down. Again, a lot of control. Lot of flexibility in the back as well. Develops all of those things. We're gonna work the anterior side here and hit the old abs, what your friends have all been asking for in their training is, when do we get to train the abs? Ab mat sit up, you wanna develop some capacity there. It's a real basic exercise. Again, look it up online there on the CrossFit site. First one we're gonna go over is the glute-ham developer sit-up to parallel. And let's see a couple reps there. There we go. Good. And this will be a starting point once they have some capacity. And actually your starting point, if I've got a new athlete up there, I really don't care what level they are. There's been some very good athletes that couldn't handle this here. I'm gonna stand behind and spot. And it may only be a couple inches at first. And then, okay, she's got control, she's good. Parallel and up. And we want to develop some capacity at parallel and the proper technique on this before we move on. We're going to cover the full ROM GHD sit up next, and then kind of go over some of the issues and concerns with this exercise. So next, again, as we set up here for either of these exercises, hip is free to move, so it's out in front of the pad or rear ends on the downside of the GHD here. Let's get a couple full ROM GHD sit-ups here. It's gonna go down, pop up, and go. And the first key is gonna be to watch the knee. So what do we know about our quads? One, I just told you it's a hip flexor, and two, we all know leg extension, right? How do we work our quads? We get on the leg extension exercise. So it has two functions. We wanna watch our knees and make sure that we're getting that knee extension and firing that quad. So as she goes down, we're gonna have a soft knee, a bent knee, and watch as she comes up, see how that leg straightens, and there we're utilizing that quad muscle to pull herself up on the GHD. So you're gonna wanna watch for that knee, soft knee on the way back, and then watch it sharply extend on the way up.